Hi there, I'm Dan Fraser, and this is my version of the 5-minute foam factory. I'm not affiliated with the folks who made the original 5-minute foam factory YouTube video, but I've made this device based on their plans, and I think mine has some advantages. So I wanted to explain what I've done differently and how this might be useful. The original 5-minute foam factory had a cut width of maybe 8 inches, 10 inches at most. This design has a 24-inch cut width, which is much more useful if you're working on big pieces of foam, bigger projects. So you can see here that I've used a long piece of wood instead of just a aluminum type post that they used in their design to get that 24-inch length. And my electric wire is stapled to the top of the piece of wood here. Now down here on the end is the little piece of aluminum post that I need to hold my wire. And my wire is right here. This is my hot wire. This is the train transformer. And when you turn that on, this hot wire does get hot. And you can see I've attached this piece of wood with some hardware here. I just sort of improvised it. It's a little bit of a hasty design. You can see that the board is not perfectly straight. It's not a big concern to me. You can see you could cut a piece of foam up to, I don't know, maybe 5 inches thick there, which is plenty thick for most of the kinds of things that I'm doing. I'm doing a lot of work in my attic lately, and I'm cutting pieces of foam to go on the walls of my attic to try to keep my attic cooler, especially in the winter when we have problems here with ice dams. So I wanted to show you a couple of interesting innovations with my foam factory. They suggest in the original plans using a piece of I forget what it's called, the board with all the holes in it. Well, I didn't feel like I really needed that. I went with a smooth board, and that makes it easier to slide foam across it. I've drawn some lines on my board at 1-inch increments so that I can see exactly where I'm at in terms of the width that I'm cutting. And I've got a piece of wood here at the 24-inch point. This is a removable piece of wood. It's got two nails in it, and it just fits in right to these two holes that I've drilled. And you can take your foam, put it up against the wood, and then run it through. Now, when I need to cut shorter lengths, say a 15-inch or something like that, I can put the wood here, and I can put some clamps. And I don't have the clamps here right in front of me, but that's what I do, is I take some little spring-loaded clamps and hold the wood in place that way as my guide. Now I wanted to show you what I've done on the bottom of this foam factory. I've taken the bolt, as they've suggested in the original plans, and attached it to the hot wire here. But you can see the hot wire runs all the way down here to the hole, and then up through the other side. And what I've got here is a piece of elastic cord. This elastic cord is connected to the bolt, and then over here to a hook. And what that does is it creates a constant tension on the wire, on the hot wire, so that it's always nice and tight and cut straight. And also, I think that it extends the life of the wire, so the wire is less likely to break, because if you put stress on this continuously with pieces of foam or what have you, it can break. And by putting the elastic in there, it gives it a little bit of an ability to flex when there's tension, so that you don't put too much tension on it. These are my rubber feet, so I can use it on my living room table if I want to. And so let's go ahead and we'll do a demonstration now. We're going to cut a 24-inch piece of foam from a 4-foot by 8-foot piece of foam, which I've got right here. So what I'm going to do, my living room space is a little bit cramped, is I'm going to move this over here. And then we're going to take this piece of foam, put that right there, and now we'll just slide it up so that it's up against the wood guide, and so that it looks fairly straight. We want to maintain that pressure against the wood as we cut here. So here we go, we're cutting away a 2-foot section from this 4-foot by 8-foot piece of foam. And it's cutting beautifully there. And we're just trying to keep it nice and straight. You can see that, you might not be able to see it, but that hot wire is staying very nicely tight, taut, as it cuts through this big piece of foam. Now you could make this 5-minute foam factory even bigger than I've made it. If you've got the wood that's bigger and the space to store it, I see no reason why you couldn't have one that cut 3 feet or 4 feet, however big you need it. It's really not that difficult to do. It's just, how big do you really want to go? Where are you going to store this monster? These are the things you got to think about here. So we're two-thirds of the way through it, and I've got my train transformer here set to about 25 or 30, and it's cutting through nicely. And my cat is walking around the living room wondering what is going on. Well, we're almost done. And now we get to a critical point. I'm going to turn it off for just a second. My foam is starting to fall off the table. So we're going to pull this back. Pull this back across here. And then we're going to turn it back on and keep cutting. You don't want to leave it on while you're cutting the foam, because it will melt a big hole in your foam. If you want it to be smooth and look nice, turn it off whenever you need to stop like that. Okay? So we'll turn it back on, and then we'll just keep on pushing it through here. And there we go. All done. All right. Thanks for watching. I'm Dan Frazier, and you've watched me use my improved 24-inch cut capacity foam factory. Thank you.